Yeah, hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad to be here and tell you something about Zahi. And I think I should give him the talk a more provoking name, like, why do you guys still use Selenium? I met in the Foston Beer event yesterday two guys. They're working with Selenium, and they told me about some problems they face, and I always were like, yeah, okay, Zahi solves the problems. Zahi is an open source test tool for web applications. An open source tool for testing of web applications. I'm working with Zahi for a few months now, and it feels very fun to work with. I feel very comfortable with it, and it's very fast and easy to use and easy to learn. And I want to present to you why it feels so easy to work with Zahi. You can create dynamic test scripts and big test suites in really with no effort, and it really saves your time. It works with a Java-based proxy server. This proxy server executes JavaScript to do the user events, like you're going to a website and you're inserting text or drag and drop or check some boxes and logging in and all the stuff the user would do, and even more. It can handle cookies, for example. And the tests are developed directly in the browser. That means you have a new browser tab where you create your tests. I will show that later. The browser independency is a remarkable feature of Zahi. Browsers, tests can be created and running on nearly every browser, also present ones and future browsers, as long as they support JavaScript. Let's say you write a test with Firefox, then you can automate the test on Opera, Safari, Internet Explorer, and Chromium, and many more. You can choose between two languages to write your scripts. Whereas I prefer JavaScript, you may prefer Ruby. It's your choice. In comparison to other tools, you have no need for weights, and you have no need for XPath, which makes dynamic websites and dynamic scripts really easy to handle. You don't get frustrated when the get element by ID changes all the time you reload the page. I'll explain that further later when it comes to the Zahi controller where you develop your scripts. Databases are handled very well. Data-driven testing, it's really fun to work with. So, when you started the Zahi proxy, you just browse to any site you want to be tested, and with controller double-click, you open the Zahi controller in a new tab. I hope you can see it right. This is the Zahi controller. Even if you have no experience with JavaScript, you can create tests just by copy and paste on the functions which offers the Zahi controller. Just insert a name, press record, and then you do your actions. You navigate, you type in text, check boxes, you log in, and everything. Every step you have done will be shown here. And you can even type in your own text in this field and test it by just one click. And you see the result in the browser. The accessing of elements is pretty easy. You hold the control button and you move the mouse over your web page, and in this accessor field, they will show up the element, the DOM element you're pointing to. You get alternative accesses anytime, so you don't need to name the element. You could say, yeah, I want the third headline or whatever. And the really neat thing is the relational accesses. The controller Zahi comes with an inbuilt API, which is based on JavaScript, and they are the commands in, under, and near, where you can locate, where you can point to an element just in relation to one another. Let's say I don't know how this text field is named. Then I just say, I want the first text field under the text box, which I know, and want to insert some text like 5 stars. You can do this with every element. You can access them by the relation in the DOM tree, just by saying, yeah, I want the third headline in the div field near the picture. I don't know. You can do everything. It's pretty easy. When you stop the recording, you just click on stop, and your test script is created. It's just a plain text file. The record, running the test manually is even easier. You just click on the playback tab. And then, here it is. Just click on the playback tab, insert the script name and the website you want to be tested, we want to get tested, and press play. And then you lean back and watch the DALL controller all the work. You will see in the other browser tab where your website is how every step is executed, and you can watch it and say, okay, everything's working fine. And when it's not working fine, when it doesn't state a success, and then when it does state a failure, then you just click on View log files, and the log files will show up. Do they show up? Yes, they show up. The log files are just a list of links, which points to these neat HTML log files, where you can just it's colorfully marked if everything went fine or not. Also you just see it in an instance if your test fails or not, and what failed. Every command is listed. Asserts like, is the element there? Is the element visible? Is the text white? Is marked in green and red? And other failures that can happen, like server timeouts or bad connections are shown there in yellow. And with just one click on every failed step or any step, you get directed to the script, and you just see the line highlighted where the failure happened. Zahi is very extendable. You can execute your batch files, your shell script. You can include any Java library you want. And just to give you an example of how you could extend it, we at Head Issue, we extended it. We wanted to get it integrated into Hudson, and Zahi should run on a server, therefore on headless. We have to run the browser headless, and with some two simple shell scripts, we created a virtual display where the Firefox or the Chromium browser runs, and a second shell script which takes screenshots on failure. Zahi has an inbuilt API which executes when a failure is happening, the recovery function, and it takes screenshots. There you can visual check what went wrong. And with the Hudson integration, it's now possible to pre-test nightly builds before they get released. And if anything fails, they don't get released. So you can make sure that the really needed functions you want to provide to your users and your clients are there and are working, whatever you do. Second one is with simple redirecting of the proxy commands. It is now possible for us to run test scripts on the Android Software Development Kit, and therefore testing mobile mobile applications in a realistic environment, in a realistic setting. Yeah, I think I talked a little bit fast. We have so much time left. that's it for now. Thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, I'm here. I think I do my best to answer them. Yeah?
Can you explain what is better, what makes SAHI better than Selenium?
As far as these people yesterday at the beer event told me, it was a lot of beer, and I don't really know if it's right, but they told me that they have the problem with the wait commands. SAHI doesn't need waits. It automatically detects when a page is loaded, or AJAX, highly dynamic content, it detects when it's loaded before executing the next step. Therefore, no failures can happen. With Selenium, you have to say, wait for like 5 seconds until everything is loaded before continuing. Or the XPath, that you have to access an element by a constant name. Get element, do you know this? Get element by ID XY. SAHI doesn't need it. Therefore, it can handle web pages where the ID is constantly changing, which Selenium doesn't. is this enough for you?
Yes.
Okay.
How would SAHI integrate with your tools like Beacon?
Excuse me, I didn't understand that. Could someone else? I didn't understand it. Sorry.
Integrate with Maven.
With Maven. I didn't work with Maven yet. We just worked with Hudson. I don't have any other information on other integration tools. So.
HTML pages,
which contain the
test reports. Are there other
formats, some formats that
Hudson can read, for example,
so you
see how many tests fail? Because HTML is not a good format for that.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's a problem. We have to convert the HTML to something which gives us some information we can handle. That's sure. But SAHI, the inbuilt SAHI just gives us HTML.
Okay, so you're working with HTML and checking visually if everything went right?
Can you repeat the question? Can you repeat the question?
Are you checking visually just the HTML? Do you have to look at the page to see if everything went right?
Right now we do, but we are just working at it that it goes automatically. That's the goal, the golden goal that... Hudson automatically detects if a build is clear or if it has failed. But I don't think this will take a long time until that is done.
Does SAHI help you to do performance testing for multiple clients at the same time?
SAHI is not so suitable for performance testing. We have here the parallel execution of tests. You can multi-threaded playback of tests, but when you do a multi-threaded playback with 10 or more sessions, it can happen then that there are unpredictable failures, which doesn't come from the web application, but from SAHI. When you have like 8 parallel executions or 5, it's okay, but performance testing isn't very suitable in SAHI. Yeah? I don't think so. Yeah, our time is nearly up. If there are any questions left, we can meet in front. Maybe you have some other ideas how to extend Sahi, and you could tell me about them. Thank you.